The efficacy of the mumps vaccine is about 80%. That is, 80% of those receiving the mumps vaccine will not contract the disease when exposed. Assume that each person's response to the mumps is independent of another person's response. Part A, find the probability that at least one exposed person will get the mumps if 10 people are exposed. So for this type of problem, I'm going to use the binomial distribution. Okay, now the binomial distribution is such that there is an X random variable. So the first thing we're going to do, we're going to have random variable X be the number of exposed people that will get the mumps. Okay, so basically X random variable will be the number of exposed people that will contract the disease, right? That's the same thing as saying we'll get the mumps. So now we know that since we're talking about total probability and the number of people and also the individual probability, in this case not contracting the disease, that's what was given, we know definitely that we're talking about binomial distribution for the random variable of X. Right, because we're talking about the n, the number of people here, and the p-value for each individual person that we will determine from this 80%. So we know that n is going to be equal to 10, the number of people, and the p-value is tricky. Notice that the p-value is going to be the probability of each exposed person having the mumps, right, contracting the disease. The given 80% is the probability of each person not having the disease, not contracting the disease, right? So we have to subtract that from 1 to get the probability of the person contracting the disease, right? So 80% is 8 divided by 10, right? When you think of percentage, you convert it to probability. 80% chance means 8 over 10 is the probability, right? 8 divided by 10 is 0.8. Right, so you have 0.2 as your p-value. Right, so we found the random variable X, go under the binomial distribution with the n value of 10 and the p-value of 0.2. So now we're ready to answer the A part of the question. Find the probability that at least one exposed person will get the mumps if 10 people are exposed. Right, so at least one person means that we need to find the probability of the random variable X at least one, so that means greater than or equal to 1. Okay, but before you do that, let's actually write the probability function. Right, the probability distribution function is going to be the probability of the random variable X greater than or equal to K. And actually let me just write first equal to k so that you know what to do. So to do that, you will have n choose k, right? That's going to be the probability function for the binomial distribution. N choose k multiplied by the p-value raised to the power of k multiplied by 1 minus p, right, the complement of that probability, to the power of n minus k, n minus k, right? So in this case, we're looking for the probability of the X random variable being greater than or equal to 1. Now, understand this. If you're looking for values 1 and greater, you're going to have to add 10 separate cases, right? When you're talking about one person, then 2 people, plus 3 people, plus 4 people, plus 5, and 6, 7, 8, 9, all the way to 10. That's too much work, right? So in order to find the total for all these 10 cases, you simply can subtract from 1 the probability of having only 0 people, right? So subtract the probability of no exposed person getting the mumps from the total probability of 1, right? And that way you will just count all 10 cases that way, right? So it's going to be 1 minus, now we use this notation, we use this probability function to substitute the random variable being equal set to 0, right? So it's going to be what? N choose 0, well, we know the n value, right? So substitute that, 10, right? So 10, choose 0. And then the p-value we found was 0.2, right? So 0.2 raised to the k power, to the 0 power, multiplied by 1 minus p, which is 0.8, right? The probability of not contracting the disease for each individual person, right? So 0.8 raised to the power of n minus k. N minus k is 10 minus 0, which is 10. So that's going to be 1 minus, and notice that this is equal to 1. Right, 10 choose 0 is 1. And by the way, 10 choose 0 is NCR notation, right? 10CR, 10 combination 0. Do that in your calculator, you're going to get a 1. And this is to the 0th power, that's also 1, right? So all of these are 1 times 1, so the whole thing that's left is 0.8 to the 10. 0.8 to the 10, which is equal to 0.89. 2625818. So just under 90% chance, okay, the probability that at least one exposed person will get the mumps if 10 people are exposed, right? About 89%. If you round it to 4 decimal places, you will get 8926, right? The 2 does not push the 6, it stays there. Okay, so that's part A, right? Now the second part is slightly more complicated. It says how many vaccinated people must be exposed to the mumps before the probability that at least one person will contract the disease is at least 0.95. So basically what this question is asking you to do, it's saying find the value of n using this formula when the probability of this is at least 0.95. Right, so basically what we have to do, we have to set the probability of x being greater than or equal to 1 at least 0.95. And then we have to use this formula, probability function, to find the value of n. Right, so we're going to have to set, now notice that the probability that the random variable is equal to or exceeds 1 is equal to 1 minus the probability that the random variable is equal to 0. Right, so that has to be set to the same thing. So we're going to have 1 minus n, choose 0, right, because we have to solve for the n, the number of people. Right, so that's going to be the probability 0.2. 0.2 to the kth power. What is the value of k? K is 0, right? Times 0.8, the 1 minus p probability, raised to the power of n minus 0, which is n, right? And that's greater than or equal to 0.95. Right, so then, as we've discussed earlier, n choose 0 is 1. Right, so as long as n is non-zero, this thing will be 1. Okay, this is equal to 1 as well, because the non-zero raised to the power of 0 is 1. Right, so basically we're talking about 1 minus 0.8 raised to the nth power is greater than or equal to 0.95. So now subtracting 1 on both sides, we're going to get negative 0.8 to the nth power is greater than or equal to negative 0.05. Now if you want to multiply both sides by the negative, you will get 0.8n to the nth power, but be careful that you understand that the inequality sign reverses when you multiply by a negative, right? So it's going to be less than or equal to 0.05. Now as you might have guessed, to solve for n we have to use the logs. So you can use either a common logarithm or a natural logarithm. It's not going to change the answer, right? But just for fun, I'm just going to use the log because that's what most high schoolers know. So I'm going to use the log of 0.8 to the nth power is less than or equal to the log of 0.05. Right? So then the n comes down. So we're going to have n log of 0.8 is less than or equal to log of 0.05. So now we can divide both sides by log of 0.8 and solve for n. But here's one little thing that you should be aware of. Log of 0.8 is going to be negative. Why? Because the input for the log 1 is the breaking point. The log of 1 is 0, right? So the log of the inputs greater than 1 give you a positive result. But if the input is less than 1, in this case it's 0.8, the answer will be negative, right? Remember, the logarithms can be negative. The inputs of the logs cannot be negative or 0, but the logs themselves, the answer can be negative. In this case, this is negative. So if you divide both sides, the inequality will reverse again to the original direction that we had. Right, so it's going to be greater than, the n value is going to be greater than or equal to log of 0.05 divided by the log of 0.8. So this is going to be equal to 5241388. So now let's interpret. It says that for the probability to be at least 95% and above, 0.95, the n value must exceed 13.42. So in other words, we're looking for the n value of being the integer, the positive integer value, because the number of people can only be counted, right? Counted by whole numbers, right? So 14 people, right? At least 14 people must be exposed to the mumps before the probability that at least one of them will contract the disease gets to be 0.95, right? So 14 people would be the answer. And again, because we have to use the integer, positive integer value, the whole number value for the n, because n represents the number of people, right? So 14 people is the answer. So thanks for watching. I hope this was fun. See you in the next video.